This is a single game from the USCA Southeast Regional American Rules Croquet Tournament held at Pinehurst in June of 2019. It's a quarterfinal match between Danny Huneycutt and Macey White, one game that is a remarkable demonstration of American Rules tactics, as you will see. They're obviously playing stripes, double banking. I'm guessing Danny won the toss and elected to go in. They're playing on the court four at Pinehurst, which is also a lawn bowling pitch. Because blue bounced off, Macey feels safe taking red to hoop two immediately. Taking advantage of the fact that the starting line is 9 inches long, so you can set up that ball for whatever angle you want. So at the start of turn five, only red is in the game and there's no deadness. And black is in a position to come in. Macey got lucky. Not only did Danny not get going, but I think red is probably wired on black. Thank you. And since black is dead on red, he doesn't have to worry about wiring. Pinehurst is truly a storied venue in American croquet. This is where Danny Huneycutt learned. The Solomon Cup is being held in October of 2019 here. It's probably every bit as important to American croquet as it is to American golf. As good as Macey White has become in a very short period of time, he's also learned that sometimes the only way to beat Danny Huneycutt is to keep him out of the game. Black is dead on red, and blue's two turns from getting in, so it's safe to set up so close to hoop one. Danny frequently does stuff like that that seems wildly aggressive. But if you think about it, if red comes through six and then Roquet's black, he's going to have to make one back. And that'll let black get clean. You know he was thinking about the wire, but was he careful enough? I'm grateful to Brian Hovis for doing such a good job on the video work. So the wire was confirmed. Macey's now five hoops ahead, and he's in position to clear blue again if he wants to. You might want to make a mental note of how many more hoops red and yellow gets. I didn't hear, but I assume Danny took the one back clearance on black. This is kind of irrelevant anyway. Thank you. It took almost 30 minutes to get the third ball into the game. Note that a missed shot like that is what most commonly provides an opportunity for a roquet or croquet out. I think he wanted blue to go a little bit farther. He still had a roquet out opportunity, thus avoiding any deadness, but I'm sure he felt that getting the break better set up was worth incurring the deadness on black. And he keeps everything over on the east boundary so that if yellow decides to come in, he's got a long shot to try to break this pattern up. Macey's gambling that Danny might not get going, and he wisely puts yellow where it can't be cannoned into the game. Looks like the gamble may not have paid off. Yellow's right in front of hoop one. So Danny's going to move it. But it'll be interesting to see when he decides to do it. Will he wait till he gets around to two back on the break? Or if he gets a good rush, will he do it earlier?
I didn't want to keep it in. Good shot, and he didn't leave me a shot at it either.
This next shot is remarkable, not so much for how he clears yellow, but for where black ends up, facilitating continuing the break. Positioning black to clear its deadness more than thinking about continuing the break, although obviously he can if he gets a good rush out of four back. This shot's a little tricky. He has to hit it a long way without committing a fault on red, which is right next to blue. And he puts it where it's guarding red's shot on black.
That was a good jump.
Cannon and getting the rush, getting the setup, that was all fun.
Yeah.
Blue is clean and for penult. There's no penult pioneer, but maybe he can rush black to penult. But he wouldn't have done that with red if he were planning to rush black to penult, so he's just going to set black up to get clean. And black's nicely wired from red, so he has to put blue on the boundary someplace for red to shoot at. And south boundary is better than east boundary for a couple of reasons. It's harder to pick up in that position, and he'll be able to escape more easily as well. And now yellow is rushable. He's daring Danny to come get him. A wide join should yellow elect to try to do a croquet out on red. He could have taken that opportunity to move yellow out of rushable position. And now with two opponent balls right together and a good rush to them, here comes the attack. You can't do a leave for blue here because it's only live on yellow. That means he has to get a rush on yellow back to hoop six.
Call a timeout.
This, of course, is where most of us would break down. Thank you. So does he rush to one back and make it now, or does he roquet yellow and go back down to two back and pick up those two balls instead? Red is in the jaws of two back and rushable back to one back. That's a little better approach to one back than he had with the yellow ball, but it's not perfect. As victimized as Macey may feel right now, he's still only a break with yellow away from getting the game back under control. I don't think he's trying for the straight double peel finish because he's not on the ground lining up this shot. But he is going to do the posthumous peel, which is not a problem as long as you have an escape ball, but it brings the peeling turn to a halt. I think he wanted to be shorter so he could rush red toward the boundary. Trying to wire red from yellow. So he's guarding yellow's shot on red with blue, which is now clean. Based on how far apart he put those two balls, I think black was probably first ball in the last turn. And if that's not the case, then yellow definitely is. And blue is positioned so that yellow can't safely join up with red. I'll have to get Danny to explain to me why he didn't put that ball on the south boundary. Black is three ball dead, and that would have given red a little bit longer shot and less to work with should he hit. So Danny prevails 23-9 with a lovely demonstration of American Rules tactics. He went on to win the tournament. Thanks again to Brian Hovis for the video footage, and thank you very much for watching.